Welcome to One North Main, Brockton's magazine show. I'm your new host, Eamon Convey. Big thanks to Jay Miller handing over the reins to me. We're going to have a lovely episode for you this week, which features a buffalo wing eating contest between the Brockton Fire and Brockton Police Departments. I'm sure that was a hot one. We have Keep Brockton Beautiful Day, which happened all around the city. The Black and Blues hockey game featuring members of the Bruins alumni team against members of the Massachusetts police team. And finally, we finish off here at the Fuller Craft Museum with a Brockton Symphony Orchestra chamber concert. Let's check out some of the action.
We are in Brockton at a local establishment. I have my sunglasses on even though we're inside. Why? Because we're about to bring the heat. The battle of the badges, the Brockton Fire Department against the Brockton Police Department in a wing challenge. Who can eat the most in under 6 minutes? Ha ha ha! It ain't gonna be easy, but it's gonna be tasty and it's gonna be fun. Oh, So what are you looking for as a photographer in an event like this? What are you looking for? Are you checking out the lighting? What exactly goes through your head as you walk into an event like this?
Yeah, get some emotion, maybe the sauce on their face.
Hope beads of sweat.
Yeah, that'll be good. We'll see what happens. I've done it before here, right when they opened.
I just have one question. Do you ever stop? It goes round and around and around and around and around. Oh, here we come. Look at that. The colossus of cuisine.
And very interesting blazing wings. And you guys have, on my count, 3, 2, 1, go. And they're off, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my gosh, look at that, look at that. They're going right after it. Look at the far end. That guy's a man on the mission. Oh my God, are you shaking already? It's incredible. We have people shaking. We have people that are already beginning to sweat.
And not a tea party.
This is not pretty. They do not have access to any liquid. They do not have any access to sauce. They are eating it as is. The concentration is just absolutely tremendous. Just haven't made any dents. We have somebody in the field up. We have our first tap out. This is absolute surgery. I feel like I've gone to the doctor's office. This is reminiscent of Dr. Tom Brady on the football field. Dr. Zhivago, a fictional character, however, a brilliant doctor performing surgery. Oh, and somebody. Looks like we have a winner. Oh my God. He has to finish what's in his mouth. Oh! 3 minutes and 31 seconds. The fine gentleman from the Brockton Police Department. 3 minutes, 31 seconds. That's not human. He's covered in sauce. Look at him, he's searching for wings, but there aren't any left.
That's all right, he's got it.
Wow. Take a bow. We still have these gentlemen grinding it out. They're still under the 6 minute mark. Anything is possible.
Wait, we got a pretty young girl. Let's see. Oh, no, man. I need to see the show finish. Oh, my gosh, at 4 minutes, 53 seconds. We have.
Oh, he broke the 5 minute mark. Another one breaking the 5 minute mark.
5 minute mark.
One day I want to grow up to be just like these men. We are on pace to have most of the competitors finish their wings. A can-do attitude. Never give up, never give in. Bite to the finish. It's a bite to the finish. It's a fight, yes, but it's also a bite. A bite to the finish. We're approaching 6 minutes, 20 seconds left. Oh, look at him take that wing in. Incredible. He wants it. Yes, he finished. Oh, my. The Brockton firefighters with an impressive showing. Brockton Police Department fought like heck, but it appears that the fire department just put on a clinic. They just put on a fire roasted fire wing clinic.
We all used to the heat. The cops, that's why they always run away. They can't get used to the heat. Get out of the kitchen, baby. It was pride and success. We weren't gonna let the cops beat us. That's all it took.
Hey man, I gotta ask, was that sweat, tears, or a combination of both?
Yes. Good stuff.
How did it feel, man?
It was good, actually. Very good.
Yeah, you had good technique. You had a good rhythm going.
I did. Just eat, man. Like I said earlier, just eat.
That's it. Just eat. You heard him.
I'm here in front of John G. Asiaf Skating Rink, where recently the 25th annual Black and Blues hockey game took place. Now, the Black and Blues hockey team is made up of Massachusetts first responders, and of course, the Bruins alumni team makes up the other squad. This game was organized by retired Brockton Police Lieutenant Peter Crone, and the Bruins alumni team is 24-0, but I have a feeling the first responders are going to give them a heck of a fight in this one. Let's check out how the game played out.
Now, 25 years, I was surprised myself to find out that we had three players on this team that were here in the first game 25 years ago, and one of them wasn't me. But it was, it's got to be the longest running game the alumni has played in their history, and hopefully we keep it going. Well, you know, we play about 30 games a year, but I always enjoy, because I'm the guy that reschedules games, and I hate it when a game that we played for 2, 3, 4 years in a row says, oh, we're not going to do another one. But that's never happened here in Brockton. You know, Peter comes back every year and says, we want to play you again next year, and we want to have the and it's, I don't know if they've always been the last game of the year for us, but the last 3 or 4 years, it's always been the last game on our schedule. So we always like to finish off the year in Brockton.
Finish off the year with the win. Your record in this game is 25-0.
I was wondering that, because I wasn't in every one, but you know, that doesn't matter. What we do this for is the entertainment value, and obviously to raise money for much needed charities, and that's why we're here. So the score really doesn't matter in the end.
We're here with a Garden legend, Renee Rancourt.
A legend in my own mind.
Renee, yes. This is one of the traditions of your April, is to come down to Brockton and sing the national anthem. Why do you do it year in and year out?
Gee, I think this is a great honor to be here, but I think this is probably like the 20th year that I have done this, and it's, you know, it's not like work, because it's a great cause, and anytime they ask me, I'm rocking down to Brockton.
3 years ago, this game happening on Marathon weekend, 3 years ago, of course, was the Boston Marathon bombings, and you had perhaps the most moving national anthem that anyone has ever heard. Take us through that moment and what was going through your head.
Well, it was an incredible moment. Again, I felt very, very fortunate to be in that moment, and it's ironic that here was what you could consider the biggest moment of my singing life, my singing career, and I really didn't even sing. I stopped in the middle of the national anthem, as you might remember, and the fans jumped in and finished the anthem, and it was something that we will probably never live through again. You know, it's a magic moment. Well, the night that happened, it went viral, and I actually had to go home and look up what viral meant. And that was that.
So we're here at the beautiful Fuller Craft Museum in Brockton, where recently the Brockton Symphony Orchestra put on a lovely chamber concert. Let's hear some of that music.
That swan is keeping Brockton beautiful, and so are we. Sit back and relax and check out Keep Brockton Beautiful Day 2016.
Bop, 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 bop
o'clock Saturday morning, the kickoff to possibly the busiest weekend of the year. What's going on today?
Well, I mean, today's all about Keep Brockton Beautiful Day, a great annual event here in the city. The mayor's office is proud to sponsor this along with the DPW, Republic Services, but really the success of today is around the volunteers. We'll have 300 to 400 people from the city volunteering this morning from 9 to 12 to help clean up the city. We've got the supplies for everybody, some coffee and donuts, get everyone out there working. And then afterwards, the afternoon, we'll host a cookout for all the volunteers back here at Heights Crossing. But you know, this is one of the ongoing challenges in the city, is to try to keep the city clean. It's a challenge, but a day like today really makes a difference in terms of getting hundreds of people out across the city, making the city look good, and it's just so important for the image of the city.
Okay, this is one of the biggest days of the year for our department. The community comes together, we give them an area to clean or to pick some litter, and then they get to come back here to Heights Crossing across from Westgate and have a cookout afterwards as a sign of our appreciation.
It's crazy, but it's true. Cupid shot his arrow and led me straight to you, you, you. Bop, bop, shoo-be-dop, shoo-be-doo-wop, bop, 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 shoo-be-doo-wop. Bop, bop, shoo-be-dop, shoo-be-doo-wop, bop, 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 shoo-be-doo-wop.
We're here with Shirley Azak. Shirley, you're on the beautification committee today, one of the many Super Bowls for you guys throughout the year. Tell us what's going on with Keep Rockin' Beautiful.
Well, this is a great event. It's become a yearly event. Every year it gets better and better. So today we're out cleaning up Brockton. We have a lot of volunteers that have formed groups, and they're out in different areas of the city cleaning up. And then hopefully they'll be back here around noon time for a cookout. Well, there's a lot of people. There is groups that are cleaning up the park, and you know, there's part of the garden club, I believe, and there's some individuals that have gone to meet up with them to clean up the park. So I hope the weather's going to be great, and they're just going to be cleaning. I hope this continues. I hope it's not just a one-day thing. I know we have a lot of organizations in the city that clean up, you know, all year long. So hopefully this continues. We really need to take pride in our city and keep it clean.
So we went to the Elliott Street Bridge. We were over at Edgar's Park. We were planting flowers over there. We cleaned up some trash at Edgar's, the Rocky Marciano Memorial. And then we hit up Court Street Bridge. Found a lot of trash that needed to be replaced, I mean, taken out of there, but that's where we were today. We was at Edgar's, Court Street Bridge, and Elliott Street Bridge. We'll probably go out a little bit after we get something to eat. So we're everywhere.
This is the first of many cleanups for you. Tell us about what you do with the Helping to Unite Brockton cleanup group.
It's a group of residents, volunteers. Every, you know, starting in spring all the way to September, we go all over the city. We've been working the past few years with DPW in the Parks Department, and just like I said, it's just residents. We've been going around cleaning up wherever it needs. You know what I mean? We speak to the city, find out what's needed, or we just pick where we want to go. So. But we do it every Sunday. Today's the only Saturday we'll do for the year, but we do it every Sunday. And it's fun just getting out there, cleaning up the city, getting new people involved.
Why is it important?
Because it's our city. It's our home. If we don't respect it and you know, help make it look better, who else is gonna? You know what I mean? And we want to inspire other people to, you know what? Just get out there on a Sunday. A lot of times we're out here with our family and friends. It's bonding experience, and we're helping to make the city look a lot cleaner and more attractive. You know, we got to take care of our home, right?
Well, we just how much this is just a great annual event, and we try to get it to grow bigger and better every year. But you know, we've got some certain days of the year here in Brockton where we have these annual events that are great for the city. I mean, this is one of them. Hundreds of people across the city today cleaning up the city. It doesn't get much better than this.
That's fresh. That's fresh. This is gonna look so good on the grounds here at the Pluff Academy. There is a ton of people here at the Pluff to clean up. It's students, it's teachers, it's members of the apartments across the street. Everybody is here at the Pluff. It's the place to be. This place is jamming right now. Let's check it out.
Together and never.
Home Depot, we've always done stuff with the Pluff Pack and the Pluff community and our Brockton community. This year we donated a pallet of black mulch, soil, plants, planters, bags, gloves, yard tools, trowels, rakes, that sort of thing, just to get the yards looking great, the tools that they need to be successful.
Why is it important?
It's important to contribute to our community, to help one another. We're all a big family. That's what we say at Home Depot. We're all a big part of the big orange family. They're part of our family too.
Now on the other side, why is it important for the Pluff grounds to be kept beautiful?
Well, so we can be proud of where we are and where we go to school. It's important for the kids to feel proud about their environment and make sure that they are proud of all the things around us, that we're not coming to school with a lot of trash everywhere or, you know, anything else that we might find in and around the mulch.
We're making the long trek from Pluff Academy over to Snow Park. We are walking it. We are braving it. It's Marathon Monday. We're going to make this long journey. We are Brockton strong. Let's go. The students, faculty, and staff here at the Angelo School keeping the grounds beautiful as always. Next stop, Heights Crossing, the finish line, the cookout. We are here at Heights Crossing. We've just parked the car. There's a barbecue. There's cheeseburgers. There's hot dogs. There's fun. There's games. What are we still doing in the car? Let's go check it out. Look who it is. It's Jack Lally. Jack, keep rocking. Right. Beautiful day. Where were you today?
Today I was with a constituent for the first half of Keep Rocking Beautiful Day, and that was a constituent. But afterwards, I made sure to get out and get here and help put everything together.
All right. This is your first year as Keep Rocking Beautiful Day as a city official. What do you think?
I like it. I like the fact that we're able to generate so much people. We're able to bring, it really is bringing a community together to take care of, look after where they live.
Thank you.
Well, thanks again for tuning in to this week's episode of One North Main. Check out our website at bcatv.org. You can also check out some of the community events that have happened recently at youtube.com/thebrocktonchannels. For everybody at BCA, I'm Eamon Conway.